You know, I don't really anticipate today being a vlog as it's travel day, but just in case something exciting happens or I feel like rambling, let's consider this the beginning. I'm leaving my comfy Airbnb here in Seward, Alaska. About to drive to Anchorage. One of the things I just want to point out that I really like about places like this, the car's right there. Like my place in Forks, Washington. Same thing, parked right outside the door. I know that's not a big deal, but it's kind of nice to just saunter out there and toss everything in the car instead of walking down 8 miles of hotel hallway. So I'm giving myself what I hope is way more than enough time to get from this town of Seward up to Anchorage, but I do have to return the rental car, got to top off the gas tank. I might want to actually take this thing in for a car wash. It's pretty dirty. I'm not really sure. Why do cars get so dirty in snowy environments? I remember up north, Pennsylvania, or it seems like in the wintertime, always our cars were just, or my parents' cars were just filthy on the outside. Something about the snow? I don't know. Text in and let us know. Some of my most memorable places I stayed, which I need to do more of with the Airbnbs for sure, because everyone has its own kind of little character. I'm not really sure what else to say about that. One more quick thing for me is I did a little bit more pre-planning on lodging for this trip than I normally do. Up until now, at this point in my life, I always kind of like that bumbling about and just kind of rolling into town, finding a place or finding a place the night before as you're traveling. And I'm realizing all of this traveling that's going to happen this year, too much not to plan ahead because I'm trying to see a lot, I'm trying to cover a lot, and that just takes time. If I could do that up front, just kind of get ahead of the game. That way, that's one less thing I have to worry about while I'm traveling, and I could try to absorb myself or immerse myself more in the location. And plus, trying to video all this stuff, I can't even imagine what it's going to be like going through all these terabytes of, well, not terabytes, gigabytes of clips and imagery. I hope I can tell some good stories. I've also been journaling. I've never really done that. Consistently, I've tried that before, and I think it's going to be nice to refer back to some of that to help tell some of these stories, specifically on the 50 at 60 website that I'm using to document this whole trip. And again, I'm in the documenting phase now. Yeah, it's time to go. All right, it's always that nervous final sweep through either the hotel room or the Airbnb you've stayed in to make sure that you didn't leave anything behind, you know? It's an odd feeling. You're leaving your home yet again. I better shut the lights off. I'll see you outside. I wasn't kidding. You think I should hit a car wash?
I mean, look at this.
So I think this is just basically going to be a general day of travel. I don't anticipate this being very exciting. As he loses all the viewers at this point. My flight is not until 2, and according to the map app, I'm only 2 hours and 20 minutes away from the airport, and it's now just shy of 8 in the morning. But I know what this scenic drive is like, and I've stopped many times, and there's clouds out, so I don't know. I have the camera up front. I may end up stopping a few times. Again, I need to get some gas to kind of top things off. Maybe get a car wash if I find one. But we don't really know what's going to happen, so I'd like to give myself a little bit of time. God forbid if I get a flat tire or something. Let's not even think about that. All right, last little view of Seward. Pretty bad view off the car, Mike. Here we go.
That was
Seward's one of those places that, you know, I passed a couple of times when I was coming into Seward, and really the reflections off of that water were, if there was a place to park, I would have gone scampering about to get a good shot, but there's nowhere to park around here. And that gets frustrating. Sometimes you'll look down and you'll see like a car down there, or like somebody wandering around fishing. You're like, how in the fuck did they get down there? I guess that's why I like to give myself a little bit more time than one night in a place, because there's no way you're going to find the out-of-the-way locations like a local unless you give yourself the time. And again, if I have some of the mediocre things done ahead of time, like lodging planning, then that just gives me more time to explore. And certainly if I stay a couple of nights in a place, I have a little bit of time to go off and find some unique locations as I bumble about. It's a lot of construction up here. Or repair work, I guess. Massive holes in the road. So this is like a glacier-fed lake, I guess. It is so, this is a beautiful blue. It's looks like Gatorade, actually. How do you like this look, by the way? No idea why I'm recording right now. So I came on to just mention, this is kind of a note to self, really work on the DJI action cam settings now, because I notice when I'm doing the hyperlapse, like I'm shooting a really long hyperlapse now, and I notice for some reason it kind of is like self-leveling or something, and it's just like as I accelerate it's going up and down, and I noticed that when I looked at a couple of files. I don't know if everyone's doing that. If it is, I gotta fix that for the next trip out. I also want to look at other ways to mount this thing, because shooting through a dirty windshield, probably not the best as a long-term strategy. Maybe externally outside of the car with multiple suction cups as safeties. Maybe on the grill of the car, being able to access, turning it on and off from the phone remotely. Look at those sorts of things. Maybe mounting a couple of them in the car. But first, I need to determine how much I'm going to use this footage in the video, so don't want to go too nuts with this. But that was an animal's tire. We're going to tweak the action cam action, because I think that's good for kind of helping tell bits of the story. It'll be fun to kind of look back at where I've driven. I've seen some of those videos online where they're literally, the entire video is just a drive. I could do that, but nah, there's enough of that out there. Mike, what we don't need is more of you talking into your camera while you're driving. No thanks. Thank you, though. I tell you what, if I find more places like this, or many more places like this, I'm never going to get to the airport. I'm so blessed and so grateful to be able to get out here and do this. And more than anything, I'm blessed thankful for my eyesight. Again, I've talked about it before. I had retinal detachment surgery a couple of years ago. My biggest fear is that I wasn't going to be able to get out and travel as I got older. And Bascom Palmer did an amazing job. And I'm blessed and grateful beyond words, especially when I see scenes like this. And I could spend hours photographing around here and exploring. and waiting for the light to change and listening to nature. But I have a flight to catch. Another car entry to the vlog. So I just want to come out and again thank my sister for when I was talking to her before, I says, you know, I'm going to be up in the Pacific Northwest. I'm going to TravelCon and I'm going to the state of Washington. And I was like, you know, Alaska though, it's so close. I was thinking about maybe, you know, trimming down a couple of those states and then flying out of Washington to go to Alaska. And she's like, well, yeah, you're right there. And thank God I did, because this is not really a state at this point that I would have been able to cover near as much territory had I come up here. My June is already spoken for with what I'm planning on doing, my July and August. So outside of that, you don't want to come here in October. Well, maybe October. But again, there's like a million other places I want to be then. So anywhere between, say, November and March or April, maybe April would have been an okay time to come. But anyway, I'm so glad I came up here when I did. And I'm grateful for my sister kind of like being like, dude, Alaska, man.
And just like we started a week ago, back at the Anchorage Airport. Pretty cool roar effect they have going on here, but anyway, what a hell of a trip that was. Anyway, I snapped a picture of a bear experience. I think the next time I come back here, I want to do that. I want to time it so I can go to experience bears in the wild, eating salmon at the waterfall. Moose Peterson did that before on a photo thing. I want to do that someday. Anyway, what a great trip this was. Looking forward to coming back here someday. Thank you, Alaska. All right, time to go home. As always, more on all this later.